Hi there! So here's my video for the vanilla peach look that I uploaded to Facebook and Instagram and all of that. I think a week or two ago, more like a week and a half to 2 weeks ago. You guys loved it, so I decided why not do a tutorial on it for you. Just a quick little thing. We're going to focus primarily on the eyes today. Obviously, if you want a full face, we can talk about that as well. But yeah. For now, this is what you've got. I hope you enjoy it. Let me know what you think after you've watched it. As you can see, I've already got my face on. You know, I've got my foundation and eyebrows and everything. I like to do eyebrows and mascara first. There are reasons for that. Basically, it's a pro trick a lot of people in the industry actually use. You put it on first so that when you screw up, because everyone's gonna screw up, you can wipe it off and you're not wiping off all of your eye makeup that you just spent like 12 hours doing. So in any case, we've already gotten that taken care of. If you want a tutorial on that, I can do that too. Just let me know. You need to get out of the way. He likes to get into everything. And so anyway, we are going to focus mainly on the eyes today. This is the palette that I use. This is Too Faced palette from one of their holiday collections from 2 years ago, two Christmases ago, the Paris collection. It was called the Grand Chateau. I got three of these little guys. This was called Paris in Love, I think. In any case, the colors we're using are going to be this guy right here, this one, and then this one and this one. So the two on the outside and then the other two on the outside. And also this, but we'll get to that. That's less this look and more all the looks, but in any case. So the first thing I'm going to do, normally I actually like to start with an eyeliner, so that's what we're going to do first. I think I want to keep this as close as possible to the original. Just there are some things that I do differently in different looks, but typically I do start with this first. I think I did that with this, so we're just gonna stick with it. So first thing I'm going to do, and excuse the light, if I look old or something, it's natural light. It's gonna happen to anyone, just I don't have a fancy pants ring light yet. So in any case, I'm going to start with this, and we're going to actually start on the lower lash line, and we're not gonna do very much. We're just going to do enough to define it. So we want to go about halfway across. You don't want to go any further than that. You don't want to close your eye up. And then you also want to go a little bit out beyond your eye. And this is going to start a nice little cat eye. Nothing ostentatious. Just do it on the other. This is a nice easy guideline for hooded eyes. If you want to do that eye makeup look with a little bit of a wing to it, you always want to make sure that your bottoms to your wings are even before you even go anywhere near the top. Because if the bottoms don't look even, that's what's going to make it look wonky. Let's see. Yeah, they're a little bit off right now, so. It's gonna look a little bit funny at this point because it's, again, only under the eye, but we'll get there. Of course, you can always touch this up. The eye pencil I'm using is an Urban Decay one. It's their 24-hour, I believe, glide-on. It's in a dark gray color. And the thing about this is it's very waterproof, so we wanna be careful with it. I'm only going 3/4 of the way across the eyelid this time because we do want a more dewy, open look. and then quickly wipe up any mistakes. I usually use a Q-tip, but that's not what I have on hand right now. So, toilet paper. Very fancy. Got a little dot here we're gonna get rid of. Now, this line I'm only using as a guide later for when I use the darker shadow for a line. So I'm not too concerned, excuse me about that. A lot of shadow palettes actually come with a darker color specifically for a liner. That's what I typically do. It's just the more classic way of doing your makeup. There are so many different things. I am not someone who wears liquid eyeliner a lot of the time. It's just not my look. I have nothing opposed to it. I think it's fun. It's a huge trend right now, obviously. But you don't have to do that if you don't want to, is I suppose my point. So, just gonna finish this down here. You don't wanna get too worried about this because, again, we are going to be using different shadows. It's not like it has to look Instagram perfect every step of the way. A lot of that stuff is heavily edited. I hope you know that. The final product is edited. Everyone does a little bit of editing these days, but in any case. So the next thing we are going to do is take this brush. This is just a little fluff brush. These brushes are from Sephora. I like them a lot. And we're going to go into that first color. It's called Amour. And if you can see, it's basically just a very matte, low-key color. It's going to go all over the lid. You don't want to go over that eyeliner that you just did. You want to just touching the eyeliner, but you don't want to go over the eyeliner. It just gets messy and it's unnecessary. And that goes all over the lid. Very easy. Other side. And that's taken care of. And this is, in case you care, the Pro Shadow. Believe it's number 14. So I like that brush. I use it for a lot. I don't use a ton of different brushes. I use mostly the same ones over and over. I find if it's not broken, don't fix it, you know. So this is the next brush I'm going to use. It is a crease shadow, also from Sephora. I think all of these are Sephora brushes. Number 73. I like this a lot. It's my favorite crease brush. So we're going to go into this next color, Je T'aime. It's kind of a bubblegum color. I know I call this a peach look. I use the bubble gum. I don't use the peach for this. So for my skin tone, I find it works better. If you've got a warmer skin tone, by all means, definitely go for the peach. We're just going to tap that in a little bit, tap off the excess and go into the crease. Just a really quick crease. The other eye. You always want to tap these colors off because you never know, even if they seem light or they look like they don't have much fallout, you never know what's going to happen. I've had some very expensive brands of eyeshadow that aren't supposed to have any fallout. They still do. Every brand is going to have a little bit of fallout. If you find one that doesn't have any, it's probably a cream shadow, and I've even had creams that had fallout. So it's just something you gotta deal with. There's a trick for that, and I'll show you that in a second when we go in with darker colors. For now, we're just doing this quick crease. Okay. So the next thing we're going to do is a darker color in the crease. We're gonna use the same brush, because, again, it's my favorite. It's a very diffused look. That's fine. We can do that. We can get away with it. So we're gonna use a darker color. We're gonna take this, because we just spent all this time doing this. Well, I did. You weren't here for that. So anytime I am going in with a medium to dark color, I'm probably going to be doing this, whether it's on you or on me. And if you don't see it in a video, it's because I got lazy and I'm hoping the camera doesn't show the fallout. But in any case, we are going to go in with this medium dark brown. It's called Moi. It's very nice. These are mostly kind of shimmery. The first one, Amour, that I put on was not. But Usually I don't use this much shimmer these days, but for this look, it's fine. It's a glowy look. So we're using that moi. Putting this right under the eye. And we are going to do the outer crease. I wonder if you can hear my cat talking or if that's just me. So, I like to kind of go along. What are you doing? I don't think so. That cat is so naughty. Anyway, so I went ahead and just after I yelled at him, I finished blending this in here. And as you can see, it's a very subtle look. We can add a little bit more to it if we want. I might do that. It's not necessary. This is a very diffused daytime look. I'll just do a little bit more just to... I don't know what's going on with that light. Everyone says, oh, start with natural light. It'll look fine. No, it really doesn't. I have done enough recording with this little setup to know that I'm going to switch something really fast. But in any case, that is pretty much what you want to do for that. And then I like to go in with this other fluff brush, which I actually call my duster. I use a lot of brushes, not the way they were intended. This is the Pro Smoky Crease. It doesn't smoke. It's a non-smoker. I just use it to kind of dust in a little bit. You know, we want to blend everything out a little bit further, even more than what I've already done. Wipe that guy off. There's absolutely no pigment on this brush other than what I wiped off just now. In any case, we're going to go in with that same color moi on the other eye. Use the same little guy here and go to town. Remember, we're not doing the entire crease. We don't want to look like we've got a black eye. We're just going about, you can go a third, you can go halfway, you can go 3/4 of the way if you really want. We're also connecting that wing a little bit. You could see that more with like a more nighttime look or a more glam look, but we'll get there when we get there, so. And this is the part that takes forever. This is why a lot of people will walk around with really crazy looking eyeshadow, because blending does actually take forever, and it's kind of annoying, but it is what it is. You've got to have it if you're going to do the look, so. I'm going to see how even that looks. Dust it. I like this one better than I like this one. Okay. And that happens all the time. You'll usually find, well, if you're a professional and you're working on lots of people, you'll find soon enough everyone says, oh, I have a squinty eye, I look so weird, or my eyes are uneven. Everyone's eyes are uneven. My eye sockets are uneven. I'm always gonna go back to the first one I did to switch it up to look like the second one because they're uneven. Everyone's are uneven, so don't let that bother you. They're looking a little more even now. This is the part where we get fed up, but whatever. Next brush we're gonna take, and we're gonna use that same color, moi. And this was totally a whim purchase for me, and I'm so glad that I did. This is the Must Have Smudge. I really like this brush. It's a little fat, chubby thing, and I love it. I'm just gonna tap that in, tap the excess. I'm gonna go under here just a little bit. We're gonna go further than this eyeliner, but we're not gonna go all the way to the inner corner because that's not what this look is about. Others you could, not this one. I'm gonna start at that that liner there, that little wing. I'm going to start smoking from there, and we're going to go in. Poke me in the eyeball. Anyway. There we go. So you can see it's a little more defined now. I'm gonna go ahead and do it with the other one. As you can see, I'm obviously still holding this under here, not directly underneath the lash. We've got to be able to get in there with the brush, but pretty close. This brush is great for if you've got a ridiculous color and you've got a lot of pigment and you want that under the eye for kind of a smoky look or like a complementary color or something. It's really cool. But for this look, it's gonna stick pretty subtly just because of the nature of the shadow that I'm using. But this is a pretty cool brush. I use it in a lot of things. So there's that. That's taken care of. And yep, we're looking pretty even. Eyeshadow, one of those things. So yes, we're almost done with this. We're gonna go back in with this guy really fast. This is my duster. I'm just gonna go into that Amore color again, that very first color that we used. I'm just gonna go up in here, blend it a little bit. The only time I really use this brush in a color is when it is the lightest color that I'm using. That means I don't have to wash it every single day, which is awesome. You obviously want to wash your brushes every single day. If you're a professional artist and you're using them on different people, it would be totally disgusting not to. These are my personal brushes. I'm not going to wash these every day, and I would not expect anyone to do so. But in any case, so this is something that, you know, I can dip in and then not have to worry about ruining the brush for tomorrow's look. So just go ahead and do that. Just to get a little bit of definition between the brow and the crease, because when you've got hooded eyes, that's a bit of a problem. When you've got smaller eyes, deep-set eyes, definitely a bit of a problem. So, in any case, we're almost done. We're gonna get a fresh one of these, because the next thing we're going to do is go in with the liner color. Very quickly, this brush, your typical angle brush, theirs happens to be number 90, must have liner. I mean, obviously, everyone should have one of these. We're going to go into that darkest color. Usually I use like a really, really dark color, but the darkest color we've got here is this one. It's called Tout Suite. Don't actually know what that means in French. I took French, but I wasn't very good at it. so I don't know what Tout Suite actually means. So we're just gonna go in there, tap it off as usual. And we're only doing this to the top line because we obviously already did the bottom line with a smudge. And you never really want to go and do that dark all the way around unless you're going for a really, really vampy, smoky eye. Which this is not what that is. So I'm going to go in. You can see it's kind of a funky line. And we're just going to kind of even it out with that shadow color. And we're gonna go do the other one. Pretty easy. And you can spend hours on this if you want. I'm just going to the mall later to get more maternity clothes. It's not something that, like, obviously if I were going to a party or an event or something, I'd spend a lot more time on making sure that that line is even. But it's pretty even. It works for me. Now I'm sure I'll go over this footage later and think, oh my gosh, what happened to my eyeshadow, but you see there's really magical effect to using your darkest color as a liner and going over that line. You get the intensity of the liner itself, but then you also get the little extra bit of color from the pigmented shadow, and then you also get to not have to worry about the line and how wonky it was when you drew it on, and it was like 7 a.m. or something. So anyway, that's the eye look. I'm just going to very quickly do face, and let's just see. I won't really go into face here. You can just kind of watch. If you want a full face tutorial, again, I'm more than happy to do one for you. So we're just gonna do some very quick contouring. Few reasons. Number one being, I feel I look better with it these days. Being 30 will do that to you. I don't do contouring the way most people are doing it these days. I don't, again, very classic look. I'm more of a classic Hollywood makeup artist than a very trendy makeup artist. I wish that light would stop doing that. And I like a much more subtle look when it comes to highlight and shadow. So let's see. It's pretty close. I can do the other one if you want. I can do it with creams if you want. I can show you a variety of different ways to achieve different effects with this. But for now, we're just doing like a very subtle kind of a thing. Quick highlight. I don't even remember what brand this is. I'm hoping this year to get some new highlighters and play around with them, because it is something that is very trendy right now, obviously. Liquid lip, that's another one, but my big thing is highlighter, so I want to try a few different brands of highlighter. But for now, this is my typical glowy highlighter quickie thing. I repotted it, it fell apart. I mean, whatever. For this particular look, you're going to want to use a blush that kind of goes with your lipstick, and you'll see the lips in a second, but this is like a dusty rose color. My lip color is going to be a dusty rose color. I actually lied when I said the eyes were done. I always forget this last part till after I do the highlight, and then I'm like, oh shoot, the best part of the eyeshadow, totally forgot. So yeah, that's pretty good. We're done with that. This is the best part. I love this. This is NARS Callisto. It's the only NARS eyeshadow I own. It's absolutely gorgeous. Let's see if we can do that shimmer. Yeah. It's really pretty. So this is a wet or dry. I typically am using it dry. For this look, I'm going to use it dry. Just gonna go back in with that regular eyeshadow. You can kind of see it. And this, we're actually going to throw a little bit on the lid and then a little bit into the inner eye, just to give it that extra glow that you guys all liked so much. So just gonna take this and put it all over. And you know, typically, yeah, you can do this before your liner. I'm not gonna get it on my liner, so it's not a big deal. That's just because I'm doing this all the time. You can also do this before your liner and, you know, your highlight and everything. But you can see we're doing the inner corner of the eye up to the crease, about half to two-thirds of the way across. We don't want to do too much. Again on the other eye. And it just kind of diffuses and blends everything beautifully. It catches that light in a way that I don't see with very many other eyeshadows, so this one I think was worth the money. I wouldn't go out and buy a trillion of their eyeshadows just because the price point is a little bit prohibitive at this point for me. Just gonna go ahead and tap the tip in and just go into the inner corner. This is a great way to finish off your inner corner without closing up your eye. Oh. And that's that taken care of. Lips, very fast and easy. I'm gonna go with a very lived-in Brigitte Bardot kind of smudgy lip, a nude color. Well, nude for me is going to be different than nude for you. Nude for me is smoky rose color. Like this one, this is a Milani. The color is Matte Darling. It matches my blush, which is also Milani. Just show you really fast. Very similar in color. I'm just going to take this. I've already put a little bit of lip balm on, so my lips are nice and moisturized. You've got to do that before you try and buff in your lipstick, or it's just not going to work. So I'm just going to take this. A very je ne sais quoi, buff it in. No big deal. I know it looks totally funny when it's going on, but it's worth it. You can see it's pretty much done. Yeah. Make sure it's even. And this is a great way to use a matte lipstick if you don't want that super defined look, or if you're not sure if it's going to look good on your lips. A lot of people don't have the like most gorgeous lip shape by today's standards, so this is a fun way to play with it and see if you like that texture, because it's, you know, textures come and go, and you'll see if it's for you. Anyway, the last thing we're gonna do is take this lip gloss. It's a dupe for the NARS Orgasm lip gloss. This is a Burt's Bees one. It's called Sunny Day. It works pretty well for what it is. I'm not gonna use too much of this. Just gonna put a little bit of it right there in the center. Give the lip a little bit of dimension. It's really all you need to do. Yeah, and then you can put a little more on if you feel like it, but totally up to you. And that's the look. So I'm gonna do something with this. This is obviously not how I'm wearing my hair. I will take care of this and then that'll be it. I hope you enjoyed it, and definitely let me know in the comments below if you know what you thought, and if there's anything you'd like me to do. I'd be more than happy to do that for you. This is for you after all. So yeah, definitely let me know, and give me a subscribe. It'd totally make my day. I hope that you guys have a great rest of the day or week or whatever, and I will see you in the next video.